Shri Gurubhyo Namaha children, I'm happy and excited to welcome you all in yet another session of your English online learning. In today's class, we are going to see chapter 8 of your class 9 English book, and this is a prose lesson children. Let's get started. So today, we are going to see the lesson, Reach for the Top. It's a biographic lesson children. We are going to see about two famous inspiring persons in this lesson. Yes? So in this we have two parts, and the part one is about Santosh Yadav. And I know you will all be excited to know who is Santosh Yadav, and some of you might be knowing already as well. Okay, let's get started children. The only woman in the world who has scaled Mount Everest twice was born in a society where the birth of a son was regarded as a blessing, and a daughter, though not considered a curse, was not generally welcome. So she was the woman, first woman in the world to have scaled. Scaled means climbed. Okay, she is the first person to climb Mount Everest twice. Okay, and she was hailing from a place where the birth of sons only were considered respectful, and the birth of a girl child was not so much welcomed. Okay, it was not a curse, but not welcomed. When her mother was expecting Santosh, a traveling holy man giving her his blessing, assumed that she wanted a son. So when Santosh's mother, so we come to know Santosh's mother was expecting, which means what? She was carrying Santosh in her womb when she was expecting a holy man. She meets a traveling holy man wherein he thinks, okay, the holy man thinks that Santosh's mother only wants a son. But to everyone's surprise, the unborn child's grandmother, who was standing close by, told him that they did not want a son. So the grandmother of Santosh, she told the holy man, okay, she told him that they don't want a son. Okay, they want a girl child. And the holy man was surprised because they were hailing from a place or from a society where sons were considered respectful. And this holy man was surprised to see somebody asking for a girl child. The holy man was also surprised. Nevertheless, he gave the requested blessing, and as destiny would have it, the blessing seemed to work. So how the blessings from the holy man were? The same way the destiny, okay? The mother, okay, she gave birth to a girl child. Santosh was born the sixth child in a family with five sons, a sister to five brothers. So we can understand why the mother was expecting a girl child, because she was already having five sons, okay, and this time she wanted a girl child, and she was the only sister, okay, who was born among five brothers. She was born in a small village of Joniawas of Rewari district in Haryana. So she was born in Haryana. The girl was given the name Santosh, which means contentment. But Santosh was not always content with her place in a traditional way of life. So the girl child was given the name Santosh. Santosh in Hindi means contentment, satisfaction. Okay, but this girl was not always content. She was not at all satisfied. She began living life on her own terms from the start. Where other girls wore traditional Indian dresses, Santosh preferred shorts. So she had an exceptional quality. She was always in that exceptional side. Okay, though she hailed from a traditional family, a traditional place, and she always refused to wear the traditional garments. Okay, she wanted to wear, she preferred wearing shorts. Looking back, she says, now, from the very beginning, I was quite determined that if I chose a correct and a rational path, the others around me had to change, not me. So from the very young age, she was determined. Determined means she was focused. She knew what she wanted. Okay, she was very clear, and she thought if she had chose a rational path, rational means what? Logically correct. Is called as a rational path. If she had chosen some correct path which is logical, it is not she who has to change, the people around her has to change their attitude of looking at her. Santosh's parents were affluent landowners who could afford to send their children to the best schools. Even the country's capital, New Delhi, which was quite close by. So the parents of Santosh were affluent. Affluent means what? Rich, well-to-do, okay? And they were landowners and they could afford to send their children, Santosh and all the other children, to the country's capital, New Delhi, just to do their schooling. So much they had money. But in line with the prevailing custom in the family, Santosh had to make do with the local village school. But in line with the prevailing, in line means in accordance or according to. According to the prevailing custom, prevailing means the existing custom in the village, the girl children are not allowed outside the village. They are not allowed to go outside the village. So she had to stick on into the same village for her school. So she decided to fight the system in her own quiet way when the right moment arrived. So she was not rebellious, okay? She was not confronting anybody, fighting with anything, okay? She was quietly waiting, okay? She was so matured in her thought. So she knew what she wanted and she did it in her own way. And the right moment came when she turned 16. So until 16, this girl was waiting patiently and only at the right moment she chose to speak against. At 16, most of the girls in her village used to get married. Santosh was also under pressure from her parents to do the same. So since I told you she hailed from a small village wherein the girl children are expected to marry at the age of 16. So her parents also had started pestering her to get married, okay, and that is the time she chose to speak to convey her thoughts to the parents. A marriage as early as that was the last thing on her mind. Okay, the last thing on her mind means the least priority she gave to marriage. Okay, she had so many other things to be done before getting married. Okay, so that was the last thing of her mind. She threatened her parents that she would never marry if she did not get a proper education. So she threatened it. Okay, she told them, no, I'll not get married because marriage is some important thing of the society or the culture she belonged to. So she threatened the parents with the name of marriage. She told, if I am not given education, I'm not going to get married. She left home and got herself enrolled in a school in Delhi. So since the parents were not doing it, she left home and she tried it her own way, okay, and she got herself enrolled in a school in Delhi. When her parents refused to pay her education, she politely informed them of her plans to earn money by working part-time to pay her school fees. So when the parents said, okay, if you have enrolled yourself in the school, we are not going to pay the fee. And this girl was not bothered. She said, I'm going to work part-time to pay my own school fee. Her parents then agreed to pay for her education. So the parents understood this girl was desperate. Okay, she wanted to read. They understood her quest. Okay, and they agreed to pay the fees so that she could continue her education. Wishing always to study a bit more and with her father slowly getting used to her urge for more education, Santosh passed her high school examinations and went to Jaipur. So she always wanted more. So she was never satisfied. We already saw, though this girl's name meant contentment, she was not always satisfied. okay, she wanted more. She was always thirsty for education, for exploration. She wanted more. She wanted to do some more studies. And the father also understood her urge. Okay, the father understood the nature of the girl. And after her high school, then she moved on to Jaipur. She joined Maharani College and got a room in Kasturba Hostel. Santosh remembers Kasturba Hostel faced the Arvali Hills. So she went to Jaipur and she enrolled herself in the Maharani College. Okay, and she stayed in the Kasturba Hostel. And in the Kasturba Hostel that faced, okay, it faced the Arvali Hills. I used to watch villagers from my room going up to the hill and suddenly vanishing after a while. So in her room in the Kasturba Hostel, which faced the Arvali Hills, okay, from the room she would watch the people climbing up the mountain, but they suddenly vanish. Vanish means disappear. Okay, she cannot see them anymore after some time. And she became curious, what happened to those people? One day, I decided to check it out myself. I found nobody except a few mountaineers. So she thought, okay, let me go and check it out, means well, let me go and find out the reason, what was it? And she found nobody were there, only mountaineers. Mountaineers are people who climb mountains, are called as mountaineers. I asked if I could join them. To my pleasant surprise, they answered in the affirmative and motivated me to take to climbing. So she asked the mountaineers whether she could join them, and to her surprise, she was thinking that they wouldn't allow her, but to her surprise, they accepted her and they also motivated her to join them. Then there was no looking back for this determined young girl. So no looking back means what? That's all. She has found the pathway she has to walk. So she started her own path of life. She saved money and enrolled in a course at Uttarkashi's Nehru Institute of Mountaineering. So she knew what she wanted, and she was also determined for climbing mountains. It doesn't require just sheer determination and will. Okay, she has to know the techniques. Yes, so she enrolled herself in the Nehru Institute of Mountaineering. My college semester in Jaipur was to end in April, but it ended on the 19th of May. And I was supposed to be in Uttarkashi on the 21st. So the semesters are getting over. Okay, it had to end by April, but it didn't. Okay, it extended until 19th of May. And she was to be in Uttarkashi on 21st. So the exam ended on 19th May, and she had to be at Uttarkashi on 21st. Okay, only 2 days gap were there. So I did not go back home. Instead, I headed straight for the training. So exams are over, trainings are about to be started, and that was scheduled on 21st of May. Since the gap between 19th and 21 was less, she did not go back home. Okay, she headed straight to the training. I had to write a letter of apology to my father, without whose permission I had got myself enrolled at Uttarkashi. So she had to write an apology letter for her father because she hadn't taken the permission to go to the Uttarkashi training. Okay, apology means sorry. Okay, seeking sorry or forgiveness is apology. Thereafter, Santosh went on an expedition every year. Her climbing skills matured rapidly, and she also developed a remarkable resistance to cold and the altitude. Okay, for mountaineering, we must understand mountaineering is a skill. Okay, it does not alone require education, it does not alone require willpower, everything must cooperate, the body must cooperate, we must know the technique, all these things play an important role in mountaineering, otherwise we could end up losing our lives. Okay, what happened? She went on expedition every year. Okay, she didn't give up. She started doing it every year, and day by day, or after every expedition, the climbing skills matured rapidly. Matured rapidly means what? It got refined. Her techniques got refined. Rapidly means fast. So she was able to understand the techniques, absorb the techniques very quickly. And she developed a remarkable resistance to cold and altitude. So, mountaineering, we obviously know mountain regions are cold places. When the altitude increases, there will be less amount of oxygen. There are so many atmospheric pressure is also will play a vital role in mountaineering. So, the cold and the altitude did not bother her. Okay, she was resistant. It was not affecting her. Okay. Equipped with an iron will, physical endurance and an amazing mental toughness, she proved herself repeatedly. So she had an iron will. Iron will means what? Strong determination, focus. Iron means what? Strong. Physical endurance. Endurance means the strength, okay, to suffer pain is called as endurance. And amazing mental toughness, okay, determination, focus, okay, mental toughness, everything proved herself. The culmination of her hard work and sincerity came in 1992. Just 4 years after she had shyly asked the Aravalli mountaineers if she could join them. So she remembers the day when she went and asked the Aravalli mountaineers whether she could join them. 4 years later, okay, she achieved her own success. The culmination means what? The highest point of success, okay, the end for her hard work came in 1992. Okay, 4 years after she asked the Aravalli mountaineers. At barely 20 years of age, Santosh Yadav scaled Mount Everest, becoming the youngest woman in the world to achieve the feat. So she was just only 20 years and she became the first woman to climb the Mount Everest. Scaled means what? Climb Mount Everest. Okay, and she is the youngest woman to achieve the feat. Feat is a challenge or an accomplishment. Okay, and she was the first young woman to climb Mount Everest. If her climbing skills, physical fitness and mental strength impressed her seniors, her concern for others and desire to work together with them found her a special place in the hearts of fellow climbers. So this girl, Santosh Yadav, was the center of attraction for her climbing skills, physical fitness, everything of her impressed the fellow mountaineers. But there was something more about this girl which made them to like her most, which was her concern. She cared for others, okay, and the desire to work together. She was a person of team building, okay. So everything about her made her the special person in the hearts of the fellow mountaineers. During 1992, the Everest mission, Santosh Yadav provided special care to a climber who lay dying at the South Col. So in 1992, when they were up to the Everest, the mission, Santosh Yadav, she provided the special care. Okay, there was a person, a fellow mountaineer was lying, he was laying and he was about to die. Okay, she took special care of him. She was unfortunately unsuccessful in saving him. Unfortunately, that person died. She was not able to save him. However, she managed to save another climber, Mohan Singh, who would have met with the same fate had she not shared her oxygen with him. So she also saved one more fellow mountaineer called Mohan Singh. Okay, he also had some problems, and Santosh Yadav, she shared her oxygen, which means what? Mountaineers, they take oxygen cylinders with them while climbing. Okay, this man's oxygen cylinder was empty, so she shared her oxygen with him. Within 12 months, Santosh found herself a member of an Indo-Nepalese women's expedition that invited her to join them. So after an year exactly, she found herself a member of Indo-Nepalese women's expedition. Okay, this organization or the expedition, the fellow members, the female members, they were on an expedition and Santosh was also called. She then scaled the Everest a second time, thus setting a record as the only woman to have scaled the Everest twice. So this is the second time she is scaling Mount Everest, and that has also been set as a record because she has been climbing Mount Everest back to back after a year, securing herself and India a unique place in annals of mountaineering. Annals means what? Records which are performed year after year. Okay, or an historic action is called as an annals. So she had been climbing Mount Everest consecutively for the 2 years. In recognition of her achievements, the Indian government bestowed upon her one of the nation's top honors, the Padma Shri. Okay, since she has accomplished so much, the Indian government, what they did, they gave her the highest award, the nation's highest award, Padma Shri. Bestowed means what? She was given. Describing her feelings when she was literally on top of the world, Santosh has said, "It took some time for the enormity of the moment to sink in." So she is now sharing her feelings about how she felt when she was at the top of the Mount Everest. She says that it took her some time to understand the enormity. Okay, she has performed something great. Okay, it was so hard for her to believe that she has done something like that. To sink in means what? To understand. Then I unfurled the Indian tricolor and held it aloft on the roof of the world. So what she did, she unfurled means what? She unfolded the Indian tricolor. Indian tricolor is the flag, and she held it aloft. Aloft means what? High. On the roof of the world, which means in the top of the Mount Everest. The feeling is indescribable. The Indian flag was flying on top of the world. Such a moment of pride, okay, such a moment of pride for the nation she had. She unfurled the Indian flag and she made it flew high in the top of the Mount Everest. Okay, that moment was magical, indescribable for Santosh Yadav. It was truly a spiritual moment. I felt proud as an Indian. So she was at trance at a spiritual moment. Also, a fervent environmentalist, Santosh collected and brought down 500 kilograms of garbage from the Himalayas. A fervent environmentalist, which means what? An ardent, dedicated, devoted environmentalist. What she did, she brought 500 kgs of garbage, of waste, okay, which the people, the mountaineers or somebody who had left it on top of there, okay, she brought them all down. So that was her concern about the environment. So I hope you would have understood the lesson, children, and you would have enjoyed it too. Meet you all in the next class, children.